In Georgia, more controversy for Herschel Walker. The New York Times is reporting that the woman who said the Georgia Republican Senate nominee paid for her abortion in 2009 now says she also urged he also urged her to terminate a second pregnancy, but she chose not to. The woman tells the Times, quote, as a father, he's done nothing. He does exactly what the courts say, and that's it. She adds, he has to be held responsible just like the rest of us, and if you're going to run for office, you need to own your life. You'll recall Walker supports a national ban on abortions with no exceptions. This new allegation comes as we learned the campaign fired its political director on suspicion of leaking the information to the press. Joining me now to talk about this is Democratic strategist James Carville, who famously advised Bill Clinton's 1992 presidential campaign. Also with us, CNN political commentator and former special assistant to President George W. Bush, Scott Jennings. James, how much trouble is Herschel Walker in right now?
Well, if anybody had any principles, he would be in a ton of trouble. And look, abortion is a complicated issue. I think he actually did the honorable thing when he helped try to pay for the first abortion woman had. He's got four children that he is not involved in their life, all right? We know what Jesus thought about that. We don't know what he thought about gays. We don't know what Jesus thought about guns, any of that. We do know what he thought about harming children. Better to tie a millstone around someone's neck and throw them to sea. He's got four kids that he's got nothing to do with, and he's being supported by so-called Christian evangelicals. Give me a break. The massive and staggering amount of hypocrisy here is beyond belief. It's not the abortion is bad enough, just another Republican hypocrite. The neglect of children is a sin of the first order that cannot be forgiven unless he gets to be involved with his children's life. It's really disgusting, Jim.
Scott, your response. I mean, there is hypocrisy here.
Question about it. I mean, look, Herschel Walker's not a perfect vessel. Republicans in Georgia, though, would tell you they don't think Raphael Warnock is either. And so they're trying to sort out, okay, what else do I care about in this election? You've got two imperfect vessels and, you know, what else is going on? The direction of the country? And the average Republican's going to say, I don't necessarily agree with his personal choices, but I don't like Joe Biden. I don't like Raphael Warnock voting with Joe Biden nearly 100% of the time. So they're going to balance that equation. He's fending off a lot of negative press right now. I do believe that the Republican establishment, the committees, are going to stick with him. I do believe that they think they're in the race in Georgia. I also think that they're probably in the field right now taking a look at it, and they won't really know until maybe Tuesday or Wednesday when they could get solid data back on it. But, you know, it's a sticky one, but I very much believe Herschel could ride it out.
James, you know, before this latest story, Republicans have tried to defend Herschel Walker. I mean, you just heard a defense right there. Let's take a listen to what the former House Speaker Newt Gingrich, someone you're familiar with, had to say.
I talked to Herschel about this morning, and I've known Herschel a good while. I think he's a remarkable person. I think he's the most important Senate candidate in the country because he'll do more to change the Senate just by the sheer presence, by his confidence, by his deep commitment to Christ, by the degree to which he is. You know, he's been through a long, tough period. He had a lot of concussions coming out of football. He suffered PTSD.
James, Newt Gingrich using the concussion excuse.
I am totally flummoxed. I'm totally flummoxed by Mr. Jennings' remark. This man neglects four children. Am I a flawed human being? Of course I am. Are you and everybody else? Yes. Child neglect is, and without asking for redemption, without reengaging with his children, denying that his children exist, trying to choke one of their mothers, putting a gun to the head of another mother, and you're going to tell me we're all flawed human beings, and you put Newt Gingrich's picture up there? I mean, there's something wrong with this. There is something fundamentally wrong. Any human being is flawed, all right? Anybody can have a difficult decision vis-a-vis a pregnancy. I understand that. Child neglect, to me, is unforgivable. If that's fine with Scott Jennings and that's fine with Newt Gingrich, then that's the modern Republican Party. It ought to be exposed.
Do you mind if I respond to that? I mean, Mr. Carville, I think, is unfamiliar with Raphael Warnock's record on this. I mean, he's got a wife out there saying he was neglectful to her, possibly abusive, and not keeping up with his child support obligations either. It's why I said when I started my answer that both of these guys are imperfect vessels, and so there are other issues in the campaign that people are going to take into account. I fully admit Walker's issues are going to weigh on some voters' minds, but so are Warnock's. And this is not the only thing going on in Georgia. I mean, a head of lettuce down there is like $1,000 a head or something. I mean, we got major problems in this country, and people are not only focusing on the personal issues of two very flawed candidates.
Come on, man. There are gradations of being flawed. Everyone is flawed. You telling me that this man neglects his children, doesn't acknowledge them, and that's happened over a period of time? I mean, get real. Is there any bottom to the Republican Party? Is there any bottom to somebody that they won't support? This is not to me. And then you trot Newt Gingrich out there, the great moral authority of all. And he says, look, Herschel has severe mental issues. He would be a great senator. Well, I'd want to have sympathy for mental patients. We ought to give them drugs and treat them. They don't need to be in the United States Senate. That is an absurd argument. And it's absurd just to say, well, we're all flawed human beings, and stop right there. That's ridiculous. It's a ridiculous argument.
Yeah, let me move on to the Wisconsin Senate race, because, I mean, the Senate could hinge on that race as well. The race there between Republican Ron Johnson and Democrat Mandela Barnes in a debate last night, the two sparred over the issue of funding the police. Let's watch.
He has a record of wanting to defund the police. Now, I know he doesn't necessarily say that word, but he has a long history of being supported by people that are leading the effort to defund. He uses the code words like Cori Bush said. Talk about reallocate.
The senator on the last question did mention, you know, police officers. Now, with that being said, I'm sure he didn't have the same interaction with 140 officers that were injured during the January 6th insurrection. One officer was stabbed with a metal stake, another crushed between a revolving door, another hit in the head with a fire extinguisher. So when we talk about respect for law enforcement, let's talk about the 140 officers that he left behind because of an insurrection that he supported.
I immediately and forcefully and have repeatedly condemned it, and condemned it strongly. But I've also condemned the 570 riots that occurred during the summer. So many people ignore those.
Scott, does that response there make you wince a little bit?
Look, I think the crime issue is rising. I think Republicans are putting it to good use in several campaigns. Wisconsin is one. By the way, Barnes is the most, if one of the most liberal Democrat Senate candidates in the country on the crime issue. I think it's also working in Pennsylvania against Fetterman, and I think it's working against Beasley in North Carolina. And people know it. This thing is rising among voters. That's why Republicans are using it. This idea of defunding the police, redirecting the money, whatever you want to call it, they're not going to be able to run away from it in the middle of a national crime wave when you've got stories in every major media market in the country about crime. And so I understand the Barnes deflection there. But overall, the issue of public safety and feeling safe when you walk out of your house or drive to your place of business or take your kids wherever you got to take them, it's a major problem. And no amount of deflection by Barnes is going to run away from his very, very liberal record on this topic.
James, is that how Democrats should go after Republicans who are involved in overturning or attempting to overturn the election results? What are your thoughts?
I think crime is a major issue. I think Mr. Barnes misspoke on defund the police. I think he acknowledged that. Ron Johnson has endorsed the Rick Scott plan to get rid of Social Security and Medicare. He's endorsed the Rick Scott plan. It would raise taxes significantly on lower and middle income Americans. All right. What you do in something like this, you say, look, what I said was unwise. You continue to support this. This is who Ron Johnson is, to sunset Social Security, sunset Medicare, to tax hotel maids. That's his idea of public policy. So when you make an error, you take a position that is unwise, admit it, and then go to a position that he took that I think is utterly absurd and destructive to people. But that's something that Mr. Barnes is going to have to do in his own campaign. I can't advise him any better than that.